Last week, Jelle Zijlstra and Professor Matthijs van Dijk explained how to define a design challenge. You learned how to come to a statement about the effect that you want to bring about through your design in three steps. This is a crucial and often very difficult step in the design process. If you got here, that means you've made a huge leap. You used a problem definition to capture, in a structured way, the main problem that you identified through the eyes of your user. Then, you learned how to define the challenge that you want to tackle. So last week was all about reflecting and capturing what you have learned so far, and about defining a direction for the creative weeks to come. As a designer, it is your duty to define a clear design direction. By doing so, you take responsibility for the design that you will develop. Such a definition will help you to drive the creative phase in your desired direction. It will also help you to argue for your design along the way and get external support for your design. It will allow others to assess the value of your design in relation to your intentions. This week is about generating ideas. Using the rich and inspirational insights that you have gathered and the challenge that you have defined, you will start creating ideas. And in this week, Dr. Carlos Cardoso will explain the basic principles that underlie idea generation. Then he will tell you about two specific creativity methods that can help you with generating ideas.